A bit loose there from Bagnaia, wasn't it, going into the first corner. He said yesterday he was not taking too many risks, not pushing to his absolute limit. He was caught out with a couple of crashes on Saturday, wasn't he, in Sepang. He wasn't going to have lightning strike twice, and that's why he perhaps was a little bit, I'm not saying overcautious, but perhaps a little bit more conservative than what he normally would be on a Friday. You can understand with so much at stake, can't you, with the title on the line here tomorrow.
Part of the lap time Ducati get, the special lap time, is on entry as well. And not just braking, but also engine braking, using the rear to stop the bike and help it turn, not push the front. And if the setting's not right, if they can't get that rear settled, I don't think they can get that last bit of time.
Really good sequence of laps being put together here by Vinales. You can see him now. We pick him up coming through the final corner. Now, this could be a potential front row lap coming in here from the Aprilia man. They're going to track him over the line now. In the middle of the circuit, he goes over the line. Not quite. Vinales, and that lap was a 1:30.029, just a whisker away from his PB lap of a 29.955. This is Bagnaia then, just building up temperature in that new soft rear tyre fitted to that Ducati GP22. Of course, the individual glory up for grabs for Bagnaia tomorrow. Ducati going for the triple crown. They're already constructor and team champions this year. Bagnaia up to seven. That's a bit more like it.
And that is the best of the new, the second rear tyre. So what can he do on the second lap? Because that's pretty much all he'll have, I think. This one or no more.
That is the best lap time that Bagnaia has mustered all weekend so far. Jorge Martin, you can just see, well, we can see in our commentary box, he's had an excellent first sector again as he tries to hammer home his advantage. He leads with a 1:29.621. Brad Binder's having a strong first sector as well on the factory KTM. He was third quickest in time attack mode in FP3 this morning. Martin, you can see him, his name on that graphic at the bottom of your screens. You can see him now charging through this third sector, halfway through sector three, into turn 10 now, into 11 as well will Martin go. He's just about to come through sector three right now. Let's check the Spaniard's progress. Somebody's gone down in our ears. I can hear there's a pop for somebody.
Sounds
there's
like
a crash
gun
for somebody out on circuit now. Who has gone down? Trying to pick out who it might well be. Jorge Martin at the moment. That's Jack Miller now. I think Miller was sent out again behind Fabio Quartararo, but Jack Miller has taken a tumble in this Q2 session on the factory Ducati, so there'll be no pole position in his final Ducati appearance here in Valencia tomorrow for the Australian. And Marc Marquez just off the back there of Jorge Martin, wasn't he? Marquez fires the Repsol Honda up into second place. Now, this is being really decisive in terms of Fabio Quartararo and Pekka Bagnaia. Fabio Quartararo, because of these late laps coming in from the likes of Marquez, Brad Binder, Pekka Bagnaia and Johann Zarco, this has nudged Fabio Quartararo now back down to ninth place. What a massive 2 minutes this is coming up for Fabio Quartararo. They have to be minimum, as we mentioned, inside that top six on the grid. He's now slipped back to 10th spot as Aleix Espargaró goes up into 9th. So at the moment, Fabio Quartararo on row 4. This is going to be a good lap time coming in from the Frenchman right now. This should be top 6. It is 6th place, so 1:30.027.
This is his last chance, this lap now, Matt. He has to do something more. I know you're saying first two rows, but he really wants the front row. So does Lynn, to give him the chance to keep the dream alive tomorrow.
There's a yellow flag out in Sector 2.
Oh, no.
And Fabio Quartararo's coming into Sector 2 right now. And that yellow flag is still on our graphic. There's the crash for Jack Miller while he was trying to go with Fabio Quartararo. Now then, this lap, I'm pretty sure that the yellow flag graphic was still illuminated when Fabio Quartararo came into the second sector. Pekka Bagnaia's taken a runoff. Johann Zarco has crashed. Now, Fabio Quartararo was on course for fourth place on this lap. I do think he may well just get over the line with seconds still to spare here. I think it's going to be mighty, mighty close, but he still may well get one more lap because we're not sure. We think this current lap he's on may well be scrubbed off for a yellow flag infringement. We're going to keep a very, very close eye on our monitors here in the commentary box as we keep a close eye on Fabio Quartararo. It's going to be heartache if this lap does go away from him, because it's a lap which could be putting him on the brink of that front row.
He's doing everything he can, and it's great to see. What a fight.
I think, Simon, it's going to be very, very tight, but I think he's going to get one more lap in here. He is. He's going to be, let's check him over the line when he comes over the line. Quartararo with 8 seconds remaining then does get one more lap.
And I don't know if he's got enough rear tyre to do a better lap time. You know, that's the problem.
That is the problem. He's got a 129.900 then.
Look at Binder on that new chassis.
Yeah, Brad Binder, superb by him. Pecco Bagnaia then has a look over his shoulder. It's session over for Bagnaia at the moment. Eighth place. Oh, Quattararo's run off. Fabio Quattararo has run off, pushing to the absolute limit on the factory Yamaha. That's what can happen. Quattararo then into the gravel trap in turn two. He rests his head on the fuel tank of that factory Yamaha. He was pushing so, so hard. Fourth place, and at best it will be for Fabio Quattararo. At the moment, there's been no information indicating that his lap, his fastest lap of a 129.900 will go.
He believed he could do it. It was only 0.2 he needed to make front row.
And as it stands right now, then it will be Jorge Martin on pole for the third race in succession here in 2022. He takes the checkered flag with a 129.621. And he's going to have dominated another qualifying session here. It is game over. Jorge Martin then takes that final pole position of 2022. Congratulations to him on the Prima Pramac Racing team. It's a hat-trick of poles to end the season for the Martinator on the front row with Repsol Honda's Marc Marquez. He's climbed off his sickbed. He was really poorly yesterday, Marc Marquez, to take second. Jack Miller completes the front row despite a late crash for him at turn two. Fabio Quartararo, it looks like it was a legal lap despite some potential late yellow flag drama. His 129.900 looks like it has stood, and it will mean Fabio Quartararo will go from fourth place, Rins fifth, Vinales sixth, and Pecco Bagnaia on course for the MotoGP World Championship. His big race will go from eighth place on the grid.